So I got my vertical done. How's it look?
That looks really good. We could probably bend that one.
So what do I have to do to prep that for a bend?
So I have this one all laid out already. This one's all laid out exactly like you have to do it. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take cut two specimens out of the plate. The specimens are gonna be located exactly 1 inch off center both ways, and both your specimens are gonna be 1.5 inches wide. What we do is we physically take that specimen of the face bend and we take one of the root and physically form them and bend them into 180 degrees to test the soundness of your weld. If it's a pass, you should have no discontinuities, or a certain amount of discontinuities is acceptable.
So I got my verticals bent up. There's a couple of spots in there. How do I know if I pass or not?
There are a couple of spots in there. We'll have to physically measure and tabulate them. According to the code, you're allowed a certain amount of those inside your bend specimens themselves. According to the D11 structural steel code, or if you're going to do a state structural test, if we have any defects or discontinuities that exceed 1/8 of an inch, then that's an automatic failure. So as long as it's 1/8 or under, it's acceptable. The other situation we have is we're allowed 3/8 total accumulation of all those inside that joint. So as long as our discontinuities, the ones exceeding 1/32nd and the ones equal to or less than 1/8 of an inch, we physically add all those up, and if it is under 3/8 of an inch, it's still acceptable. So anything that's less than 1/32nd or less doesn't exist. As long as it falls in between there and comes out less than 3/8 of an inch, it's deemed acceptable by the codes. So we went through and measured the actual sizes of the discontinuities in your bend specimen. You had one specimen that was clean, the other one's the only one with the discontinuities in it. When we measured them, we went through and found 4 of them that we could measure. We have one that measured 1/32nd of an inch, one that measured 3/64ths of an inch, one that measured 3/32nds of an inch, and then one that measured 1/16th of an inch. Now we have to use this criteria to determine exactly what ones we need to add up, and as long as it still comes in under 3/8 of an inch, your test would be acceptable.
So we got the equation written down. There's only 3 of them there. Is that because that 1/32nd wasn't over 1/32nd?
That is correct. It has to be exceeding 1/32nd of an inch. Otherwise, the D11 structural steel code deems it not being something that we need to tabulate. It doesn't exist. So our equation technically is 3/64 plus 3/32nd plus 1/16. A lot of calculators have the fraction button on it. You could type that in. In this case, we're going to do the math. What we want to do is find a common denominator straight across the board. 64th being the largest one up there, we'll put everything in 64ths. So when I take 3/64ths and drop it down, all I need to do is double the bottom to come up with 3/64ths. So if my denominator doubles, so does my numerator. So then I end up with 6/64ths. If we take 1/16ths, I have 1/16th of an inch. I need to get that to 64ths. Multiply both of them by 4. That'll give me 4/64ths. Tally up 3/64ths plus 6/64ths plus 4/64ths. Gives me 13/64ths. And if we take the math and figure out that what our defect total size was allowed was 3/8 of an inch, that's actually 24/64ths, which makes your test a pass and acceptable. Nice job.
Thank you.
You're welcome.